Now, I'm not doing too great following this tree, but watch y'all look at that. Look at those growth rings. A nice orange colored wood, and then the sapling white colored wood on the outer edges. Looks a lot like Osage orange to me. Anyways, we're going to use some of this stuff. That's the stave I'm getting right there. And then I'm cutting it off right there at the before the knot, the twin split. And that whole thing is, I don't know, probably 6 foot. Plenty to make about, sorry about that. Apparently we got some soccer games going. Anyways, that's enough to make about, I'm guessing 5 or 6 bows out of right there. Maybe more, we might get 10. I'm really lucky and I do laminations. So we will see what comes out of this bad boy. Oh, the best part is, I found it in my backyard. My mom planted this mulberry tree like 10, 15 years ago. And I just started doing some research on it and I realized how hard it was to cut. I cut it a few times, trying to trim it up and just prune it. And I was like, man, that's some strong ass wood. Anyways, it's in my backyard. All right, YouTube, so I'm gonna go over some of the tools that we might need to split this log. Anyways, let's get right into it. All right, so here we have a mulberry branch or tree that I cut down. Oh, let's get a good look at it here. It's about 6 foot long. It's probably 10 to 12 inches in diameter. Maybe 8 in some points, probably at that lowest point right there. So we're gonna need some tools to split this thing in half. It kind of split on me when I was cutting it. So I'm just gonna take this natural split that's already going down it. We're gonna split that seam. But before we do that, I was gonna go over some of the tools I got. You're definitely gonna need two of those. So that's a 5 pound wedge right there. And I think that other one's a 5 pound wedge too. It's just angled a little bit differently. Got a pretty good hammer. I got another split wedge that's for hammering. And then I got a little crowbar, a heavy duty crowbar. Also got my cobalt impact hammer, portable. So we'll see what I'm gonna use to get all this. We'll see how it comes out.
Harder than I think. opening up slowly. Surely.
Show you what's going on here.
What the camera angle ain't showing you is that the log is splitting. Slowly but surely it is splitting right down that seam that broke out from where I first cut it. You want to stay on that seam because you don't want to run any of the wood outside of that edge. You want to keep that seam going, and then you might split it one more time. You might get two or three staves out of it. Anyways, that's what it looks like. This is Mulberry. It is a cousin to the Osage Orange, and a lot of this wood has the same DNA, same grain structure. It's very good, hard bow making wood. Alright, what you're looking at is that tree split. I got a perfect split on it. Not all the wood came out perfect. Right here we got a little rip. Where down here where the tree was growing had a hard bend. Right here, it does kind of rainbow. Well, the tree actually twisted probably about 2 or 3 inches as it was growing upwards. And that wood kind of twists and splits down there on that end. Also got a big knot right here that'll have to be addressed. I may saw that out before I split it again. But I'm going to try and get a really good split right down that center. At least one more. Now this piece here don't really look usable. Right here. Don't really look usable. But if I let that dry, there's probably still a small bow there. And it goes all the way up here. So I may have to cut it like right there and then get a bow underneath it. Maybe, potentially. If you look at it down here, there's a decent piece of wood there. You can see it. I might be able to get a bow out of it. But highly unlikely. Not one that's going to last. Probably going to break up on me. So anyway, this is the main piece of wood we're looking for. Right here, we got a good split on it. We just need one more good split on it, and we might have two good bows out of that one. We will see. Just remember, when you fall these trees, hold on. So I'm going to show y'all. Show y'all the tree that it came from. My mom planted this mulberry tree about 15 years ago. Let me turn this around real quick. Show it to you. So this is the tree. This is where it came from. That is the tree, and this tree will produce red mulberries. This is a red mulberry tree, so it don't look like much, but if you look at it right here, you can see that orange wood, and obviously by cutting it, you can see the orange colors in it. Same thing as Osage orange. You can see this orange color on the bark. Orange color just comes through the bark, and well, that's what you're looking for. You're looking for a good hardwood that's going to last you 20, 30 years. You don't want to go to all the trouble to bow a bow if it's just going to snap and break on you. And I found this out the hard way. I've broken three of them so far. I used inferior woods with it. I wasn't happy with the build. Never got them on camera. Didn't care to. I was just starting out. I knew I was going to break some. But when you're looking for high quality wood, this is what you're looking for. You're looking for that orange, Osage orange color. That hardwood color in the center. You can see the white sapling on the outer edges. That's all new growth. You can see that 10-year growth down there at the bottom. You can see how it turns a bright orange color right there and all the way down. That's what you're looking for when you're looking for good wood. So the more I look at this split, the more concerning it gets. Right here we have a knot. Right here we have a giant knot. And that giant knot runs all the way through the center. So that's very concerning. And the more and more I look at this piece, it's probably got about a 6 to 8 inch diameter. And I'm betting that I didn't cut it a big enough piece. That tree wasn't quite big enough. I might be able to get one or two bows out of that. I still need to split that down the center. But you can see those two knots. Those are going to cause major problems. And I did not see those when I cut this thing down. But anyways, I can definitely get some laminations out of it. That's what I cut this tree down for. So I'll just have to use, like, let me show you, like, from here down, I can get some laminations out of it, and then cut on this side from here down. So I can still get some laminations out of it, which I can still make bows out of it. But for traditional bow build, this is not going to be the piece. And the good thing is I've cut this tree for lamination, so those knots are not going to matter. I mean, they won't go in the laminations. Anyways, we'll see what happens. I got to split it one more time, and then we got to get it up on the rip saw. Maybe we can get some lambs out of it. this is the piece I'm working on. You see it, I got it straightened up. And I've already got one lamination out of this white wood. Let's shit. Edit. Sorry about that. Anyways, here's one of the pieces. One of the lamination pieces I've got off it. I'll give you a little idea kind of how I'm doing this. I bought this rip guard for about 20 bucks. I got the saw for about 80. Got 100 bucks into it. And I'm cutting my own lamination. It's dirty work. There's a lot of sawdust involved, but they're going to warp out if I don't strap them down when they dry. But as you can tell, perfect lamination. See it bowing? And obviously the thinner you go on this blade, the thinner the lamination you can get. But you want them kind of thick when you first cut them. So when they dry, you can dry them straight and then you can work them down with a sander later. You can sand all that, any of that stuff left over on it. There's a little bit of rotten wood still on it. That'll just get sanded out. Anyways, there we go, laminations. 1-on-1. I just wanted to show you, I'm gonna make some handle pieces out of this piece right here. Anyways, I wanted to show you how beautiful this mulberry is. That's just a knot. And isn't that pretty? Anyways, cut the tip of that knot off. And that'll be getting ribbed down into, looks about 10 inch sections right there, give or take. Those will be for handle pieces. I just wanted to show y'all what you look like when you cut lemonade. You get the side. Huh? Get dirty, man. Get dirty. Get dusty. Saw dusty. It's all over your face. Man. It's worth it, though. Because I'm going to save thousands of dollars. Some people would say, oh, that's too much work. Why would you do that for a bow? Well, I'm making lots of bows. I'm thinking about turning it into a company, you know, like a legitimate resale bow company. So why not? You want to invest a couple $100 into it? Might as well invest a few more hundred and just go for it. Why not? Here I am, about 3 hours later. Here's my lambs. I got about 6 more of them cut. And I got this left. See, I got a split right there, but anywhere I see splits, I just cut it up. Anyways, I'm getting some good lambs out of it.